Ladies and gentlemen, you know her from mostly from Saturday Night Live, but I've had a fabulous conversation with her, and I'll try to do it again for 5 more minutes. Julia Sweeney. She did play one of the most fascinating characters on TV, or I've known a lot of these people in real life. The television character was Pat.
Yes.
Remember that?
Yes.
Did you invent that, Julia? Was that a creation of yours?
Yes, it
based
was.
On friends of yours?
It was based on a coworker. I used to be an accountant, and I had a coworker, but it was really a couple of coworkers, mostly male, but another female coworker.
Has that Pat thing dogged you low these
yes,
pushing
has.
20 years later?
Yes,
people
it
go,
is.
Hey, can you do Pat for me? What was it? Were you a man or a woman? Does it bother you?
Yeah, a little, yeah. I mean, I'm also...
Oh, that sounds like a lot to me.
No, I'm actually, now that I'm older, I realize how rare it is to hit like that with the popular culture. And that I could easily have done 4 or 5 other characters on SNL that weren't as popular as Pat and not be known, and because of Pat, I'm known. And I totally appreciate that.
4 years, given...
It is a nightmare, though, that I was Pat.
Well,
I mean, like,
I know. Like I'm sure it's
that,
like when
it's also a nightmare.
It's like when people walk up to Eddie Murphy and go, do kill that landlord thing for me, will you? Remember that? Nobody remembers that. You remember that. C-I-L-L, kill my landlord. You're a poet in that thing. 4 years, given recent Saturday Night Live, where people seem to stay on for 35 years.
Yes, a long time.
4 years,
four
worthwhile.
And a half.
And why did you leave? Why did you decide to leave?
You know what? That's a really good question. I wish I could go back and ask myself, because I left before my contract was up, but I felt like the last year that I was there, I wasn't really being used. And I like the first 3 years I was there, I mean, I don't even mean to complain. I was so lucky to be on that show. Totally feel lucky. But I also felt like I was played out. Like they weren't casting me in parts, and the whole tenor of the show was changing. And I had youthful gumption and felt that I was going to go on to bigger and better things. And I left.
Is that not incredibly admirable in this day and age?
No,
wow.
I think it was admirable and stupid. Like, I don't even know which. It was what it was. It was actually good for the long-term reasons, but I have spent time looking back thinking, why did I leave that? I should have stayed. I should have weathered it out and, like, waited for it to come back.
But complacency can come into that. I mean, you're a creative person, and you went out and challenged yourself by creating one-woman shows.
Well, the thing, though, was I left SNL, and
then
immediately had a huge bomb of a film with its Pat, which 10.5 people saw. And then I got cancer, my brother got cancer. So it wasn't a great year after I left. It did not turn out to be a good next year. I thought it was bad at SNL. Oh, no. It could get so much worse,
happened. You really think you would have not gotten cancer if you stayed? That's a
no.
A pretty big leap of faith.
No, I don't think that. But it is, you know, I don't know, whatever. It is what it was.